We're so glad that you're here to join us again this week. We're out in the rain today, but we're still going to praise Jesus together. Okay, let's sing Kids Under Construction.
Kids under construction, maybe the paint is still wet. Kids under construction, the Lord may not be finished yet. Dear Jesus, please make me more patient and kind, and help us to be more like you. And make room for all other children of yours, for they are still growing up too. Kids under construction, maybe the paint is still wet. Kids under construction, the Lord may not be finished yet.
Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me, yes, Jesus loves me, yes, Jesus loves me, the Bible tells me so.
Good morning, boys and girls, and a very happy Sabbath. I am so excited to be with you for another
Nature Nugget.
And this week's Nature Nugget animal truly is one of my favorite animals. I can't wait to see if you guys can figure out what the clues are for this week's Nature Nugget
animal. Hello, boys and girls. So we're going to review this week's Nature Nugget animal. The first clue is
there's 305 different types of it.
And the second clue is
it loves eating carrots.
So, let's think about it. Do you guys know what it is? It's a rabbit!
This week's Nature Nugget animal is one of my personal favorites. I love bunny rabbits, and I am so excited to share with you some fun facts about the rabbits. So let's begin by talking about what bunny rabbits look like. Rabbits are small, furry mammals with long ears, short, fluffy tails. They have little eyes and a cute little nose, and of course their whiskers, and they have two strong, large hind legs. They also have two pairs of sharp incisor teeth. One pair is on the top, and one pair is on the bottom. They have a total of 28 teeth. And did you know that a rabbit's teeth never stop growing? I know, I was so surprised by that too. Instead, they're gradually worn down as a rabbit chews on grass and wildflowers. This helps them from getting too long. The rabbit's eyes are also another unique characteristic. Did you know the rabbit's eyes are on the side of their heads? Meaning they can almost see all the way around them. This helps them to keep a very close watch for predators while they're going about their business. Another one of a rabbit's best features is, you guessed it, their long ears. Their ears can grow up to 10 centimeters in length, and rabbits can turn their ears almost 180 degrees. This also helps them be able to keep a careful listen out for predators. There are more than 305 species of rabbits around the world. And while they live in many different environments, they have many things in common. Some rabbits are about the size of a cat, and some can grow to be as big as a dog. Small rabbits, such as a pygmy rabbit, can be as little as 8 inches in length and weigh less than a pound. Larger species grow up to 20 inches and weigh more than 10 pounds. The world's longest rabbit, according to the Guinness World Records, is the Flemish giant rabbit. And he weighed in at 49 pounds and a whopping 4 feet, 3 inches long. Let's take a moment and look at a video that shows this rabbit. He truly is a giant. Did you know a rabbit's fur stays the same color all year? While his cousin, the hare, its fur changes from brown or gray in the summer to white in the winter. Did you know when a baby rabbit is born, it is born completely hairless and it is completely blind? Now we're going to talk a little bit about baby bunnies. Rabbits breed 3 to 4 times a year, and each pregnancy produces about 3 to 8 babies. And a baby rabbit is called a kit. After about 4 to 5 weeks, a kit can care for itself. In 2 to 3 months, it's ready to start a family of its own. A male rabbit is called a buck, and a female rabbit is called a doe. Now we're going to take a minute and talk a little bit about what rabbits like to eat. Rabbits are considered herbivores, which means they feed on plants. Now they love to eat things like grass and flowers and, of course, carrots. Bunny rabbits love to get into gardens, so that is why they're not always considered a gardener's friend. We're going to talk about where rabbits like to live. Rabbits are furry digging machines. Not only do they have very sturdy, sharp nails, but they are also extremely efficient front paws that allow them to scratch and scrabble at dirt for long periods of time. So rabbits love to dig. Most wild rabbits need a warren, and a warren is like its home. In order to hide from predators such as fox and wolves, rabbit warrens are often have many different chambers or rooms inside of them and lots of different entrances and exits. Rabbits spend quite a lot of time digging and maintaining these structures. Rabbits are very social creatures that live in groups called colonies. This is another reason that they live in warrens. Rabbits live in burrows underground. So we've already learned a lot of fun things about rabbits, but I think the two most interesting facts about rabbits are these. First, rabbits perform an athletic leap known as a binky. That's right, a rabbit binky. And they do this when they're happy. A rabbit binky is when they jump and twist, sometimes in both directions at one time after another, before landing. They can even do this impressive move while running, which is also a hilarious treat to watch. Bunny binkies are a common house rabbit behavior that expresses its happiness and comfort. Shall we try to do a rabbit binky? I think it'll be fun. Let's do some of the rabbit binkies that we see on TV. Let's see if you can do them. Ready? Here we go. Nice job, guys. I had fun doing the binky, didn't you? Let's get ready and learn some more fun things about the rabbits. Rabbits are amazing athletes. They can jump as high as 90 centimeters in one leap. The second interesting fact about rabbits is They purr like a cat. Purring for a rabbit is a lot like purring for a cat, in that they both mean they're happy and content. However, cats purr using their throat, while rabbits purr by making the sound by lightly rubbing their teeth together. Rabbits make a lot of other noises besides purring. The noises rabbits make when they're happy include purring, sighing, honking or grunting, and when they're distressed or not feeling well, they make sounds such as loud yelping or squealing, and even sometimes screaming. If your rabbit is angry, it will growl. Rabbits make noise to communicate what they think or feel. Well, boys and girls, that wraps up another nature nugget. I hope you had as much fun as I did learning about the bunny rabbit. And remember, Jesus loves each one of us so very much. And just like it says in Steps to Christ, we can learn more about Jesus in nature when we look at the trees or the flowers or a passing cloud. It all speaks to our heart and invites us to become acquainted with Jesus, the creator of us all, including the adorable bunny rabbit. The clues for next week's
Nature Nugget.
Clue number one is,
it weighs 14,000 pounds.
And the shape of its ear is the continent that it's from.
All right, boys and girls, there are your clues for next week's
Nature Nugget.
We hope you have a happy Sabbath.
Bye.
We have a new song for you, and some of you are going to know it, but we'll start slow with it since it's a new one.
I am so glad that our Father in heaven tells of his love in the book he has given. Wonderful things in the Bible I see. This is the dearest that Jesus loves me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves even me.
Let's do it again.
I am so glad that our Father in heaven tells of his love in the book he has given. Wonderful things in the Bible I see. This is the dearest that Jesus loves me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. Jesus loves me. I am so glad that Jesus loves me. Jesus loves even me.
Good job.
I will be saying one of my favorite passages. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restored my soul. He leadeth me inside of the path of righteousness. For his name's sake. Yeah, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest the table before me in the presence of my enemies.
Thou anointest
my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Psalms 23.
All right, the next song we're going to sing is In Right Out Right. We'll start slow and get faster.
I'm in right out right, up right, down right, happy all the time. I'm in right out right, up right, down right, happy all the time. Since Jesus Christ came in and cleansed my heart from sin, I'm in right.
Sure.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm in right, out right, up right, down right, happy all the time. I'm in right, out right, up right, down right, happy all the time. Since Jesus Christ came in and cleansed my heart from sin, I'm in right, out right, up right, down right, happy all the time.
You think you can do it faster?
I'll try.
Okay.
I'm in right, out right, up right, down right, happy all the time. I'm in right, out right, up right, down right, happy all the time. Since Jesus Christ came in and cleansed my heart from sin, I'm in right, out right, up right, down right, happy all the time.
Good job.
Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to you.
Hello, boys and girls. This is Aunt Fernita, and I have a wonderful story for you called The Poor Widow's Offering. Today's memory verse is from 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 7. It says, God loves a cheerful giver. The message for today's story is we worship God when we give cheerfully. Have you ever watched how people give their offerings in church? How do you think it happened in Jesus' time? Jesus was sitting with his disciples in the temple, watching people bring their offerings. In those days, people took their offerings to the temple court and dropped them into collection boxes. There were many rich people in Jerusalem. They lived in nice houses and wore fancy clothes. They also had plenty to eat. After they paid for their nice houses and fancy clothes and good food, they would take some of the money they had left to the temple for an offering. Dressed in their finest clothes, they would go to the temple when they knew a lot of people would be there. After looking around to make sure people were watching them, they would pour their money into the collection boxes. They liked it when their money made a lot of noise, and they liked it when people turned to see who had put so much money into the collection box. They hoped people were whispering, "Look, see how much offering that person brought? He certainly is generous." Jesus knew that those rich people brought only what was left over after they had purchased all the things they wanted. He knew that they had not given up a single thing. They had not gone hungry or done without fancy clothes. They had not sacrificed. Then Jesus noticed a woman at the collection box. He knew that her husband had died and that she was a widow. Many times she had no food to eat. The woman looked around to see if anyone was watching. She was very embarrassed because she could only bring a very tiny offering. When she thought no one would see her, she slipped 2 tiny coins into the collection box and hurried away. But Jesus had seen her. He had seen the 2 tiny coins she slipped into the offering box. Jesus said to his disciples, "This poor widow has put in more than all the others. She has given all that she has." All that she had, all of her money. As the widow heard Jesus' words, tears of joy filled her eyes. She had no money to buy bread for dinner, but she was happy to give an offering to God. Although her offering was tiny, she gave more than all the others because she gave it cheerfully and out of love for God.
This podcast was brought to you by gracelink.net and Studio El Piso in Singapore. For more children's resources, please visit gracelink.net.
All right, we're going to sing God is so good. Remember, God is so, and then good, as you bring down to your hand. So my hand should be, oh, Jen's going to show you. Good. Okay. And then he's so good to me. All right.
God is so good. God is so good. God is so good. He's so good to me.
Let's do I love him so.
I love him so.
Hi, we're the Armor Family,
and in our Armor Family worship song is
Confident.
warrior. You're afraid to lose. You won't fight for what you're calling me.
We're going to sing is Give Me Oil in My Lamp. Give me oil in my lamp, keep me burning. Give me oil in my lamp, I pray. Give me oil in my lamp, keep me burning. Keep me burning till the break of day.
Fall. told him. Yes, he was a mighty holy praying man. He said, thrown to the den of the scary beast. But God saved a hero from the lion's teeth.
Going to do the B-I-B-L-E. Remember the sign language. B-I-B-L-E. Okay, we'll try to go slow on that part.
The B-I-B-L-E. Yes, that's the book for me. I stand alone on the word of God. The B-I-B-L-E.
Try it again.
The B-I-B-L-E. Yes, that's the book for me. I stand alone on the word of God. The B-I-B-L-E.
Good job.
Zacchaeus was a little man, a real little man was he. He climbed up in a sycamore tree, for the Lord wanted to see. As that Savior passed that way, he looked up in the tree. He said, Zacchaeus, you come down, for I'm going to your house today. For I'm going to your house today.
Thank you so much for joining us today. It's so much fun to get together and praise God. Hopefully we'll be able to be together soon, but while we can't, we can still praise God from our homes, and we can do that together in a way. So thank you for joining us. Let's pray together. God, I just thank you for this day. Thank you for the rain that you've been sending to make everything so beautiful. Thank you for the music that you've given us that we can praise and worship you. And thank you that you truly are so good to us. We love you. Amen. Happy Sabbath! I hope everyone had fun watching this week's Sabbath School video. I know I really enjoyed it. And thank you so much for all your videos and your Monets that you sent in this week. They were just lovely. I would also like to take a moment and invite our YouTube viewers near and far to make and submit a short video, 3 minutes or less, of your family singing one of its favorite worship songs. Please email your family's video to kidsworshipingjesus@gmail.com. And each week, we will select and feature a submitted video on one of our upcoming YouTube Sabbath School videos. All right, I'm so excited to see some videos. Thanks again. Happy Sabbath.